All right, guys, I want to give you the number one thing that you need to be practicing as a worship bass player. Now, most worship bass players are just shooting for the root about 100% of the time, and you are still going to continue to do that when you're playing. You're going to mainly be looking for that root note. It's the way that you hold down and are the anchor to the worship set and the rhythm section in your band. But if you aren't aware of the other notes in the chord, you're not going to be able to express everything that you want to say musically in a worship set. And you're going to be able to really spice some things up when the song calls for it, if you're aware of the entire chord. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you exactly how I practice this and how I practice it with all the bass players in our Worship Plus community. The way that we do it is we grab a chord chart from your worship set. I have our worship set sitting in front of me this week. We're doing Every Good Thing by River Valley Worship. We're doing it in the key of E. And I'm going to look at this chord progression, and instead of just playing the roots, we're doing it in the key of E, like I said. Instead of just aiming for E, I'm not going to just aim for E. I'm going to play the other notes in the chord. What are those notes? The root note is obviously in the chord. We're going to call that one. The next note in the chord is three, and that's the third note from the major scale starting on E, right? So one, two, three. That's the second note in our chord. The fifth note in our chord is the last note in the chord. Chords are made up of three notes as a basic triad. Now, we'll get into in later videos how to play chord extensions, chords that have more than three notes, but for now, our chords are going to have three notes: the root note, the third, and the fifth. Now, no matter what chord we play, if it's a major chord, we can use that same shape. Here's E, the third is right here, down a string and back one fret, and then here's our fifth, there's our root. And they maintain this shape, right? If I wanted to play a C major, I could play it like this, same shape. D major, F major. And so that's how I'm gonna arpeggiate through. Now, this particular song, it goes E, then it goes A, goes up to C sharp, but now that's a minor chord. So when you play a minor chord, what makes a minor chord a minor chord is flatting the third degree. So let's go back to that E. Here's my root note. Now I'm going to play my third. There's my third degree. One, two, three. And I'm going to flat it. That just means to move it down a half step, right? So one, flat third. My five stays in the same place. Now this is a big stretch. That's a very, very big stretch. What most bass players do is they take it from that D string here. Here's my root note. There's my flat third. That note is also here. It's a G. And I can play that note much easier off of that same string as my root note. So much easier way to play that. That's the shape we're gonna use for today. So now we have two shapes, E major, root note, third, fifth, E minor, and whatever I'm pointing at, that's the chord that I'm playing. So our song goes E, A, C sharp minor. Now, I'm going to go right here for the C sharp. There's my flat third. There's my fifth and back down. And then the song goes to B. So I can find that here. All right, let's try with a metronome. So what I like to do is I'll even take the metronome speed from the song. So this song is at 112. Here's our metronome. E, A, C sharp, B. Now, one's a little quick. I realize you're not going to start off there. And also, listen, don't start playing your worship songs like this. Your worship leader is not going to appreciate you walking like you're some blues player or like you're playing giant steps and jazz. They're really not going to appreciate if you start walking through every chord in the progression. This is not for your everyday, every song use in a worship set. In fact, you're probably never going to walk through a contemporary worship song like that. What this is doing is it's giving you the options where when you look at the fretboard, when you're playing a song, you're not just seeing those roots as targets. You're also seeing those extra notes. I'll give you, for instance, let's say we were playing in the key of G, another song in our sets in the key of G, and it goes from the chord G to the chord C. Well, maybe instead of just going G and then up to C, I can play the other notes in that G chord before I have to move to C, maybe like this. Right? Now, a lot of the time, bass players are aware of what's called walking, but they don't understand the rules of it. They just kind of find notes that sound good next to wherever they're going. This is what real bass players, what great bass players are thinking about. They're thinking of the arpeggio. They're thinking of the rest of the notes in the chord that everybody else, all the other players, the piano players, the electric guitar players, acoustic players, they're all playing three notes when they play a G chord. They're playing G, they're playing B, and they're playing D. And a good bass player is going to reference those other notes to add a fullness to the sound as the chords move and change. So let's try it again. So we're playing a G chord and we're going to a C chord. G, and then I can go to my third of the G chord before I go to C. I could also go to the fifth. Maybe I go G, I play the fifth of that chord, and then go down to our C chord. Now, we could do that throughout the progression, but those just little subtle additions, those tips of the hat to the other notes in the chord are the thing that are going to make you an amazing bass player. And the way that I want you to practice them is grab a metronome, start it off slow. Let's put it down on 80. And let's say our chord progression is G, C, D. You're just going to do it like this. You're going to play every click on the downbeat. You're just going to walk up and down the arpeggio. So the G would be G, right? Here's our third. Here's our fifth. Let's do it a little bit faster, and we're going to come back to that third. Here we go. Now our C chord. Now our D chord. Back to our C chord. G chord. Now that's all the same shape because all of those chords are major. Let's add a minor chord. Let's go E minor, D, C. E minor would be this, right? We're gonna add that E minor. We're gonna go down to D major, down to C major. Here we go, E minor, D, C. One, two, ready, go. There you go. Go grab your worship set for Sunday. Use it to dictate all of the different ways that you can add this arpeggiating practice into what you do on the bass. Now go practice.